Yo, 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 when you come to hot cocoa, Papa C is in the house.
Hello, this is the amazing Papa. I'm going to talk a little bit about the Blue Sound Node 2i I bought. I bought it a couple weeks ago, maybe 3 weeks. I wanted to use it for a bit before I talked about it. This won't be like a professional review by any means. I'm just a normal guy with a normal setup, nothing expensive, just enjoy life. And I think some audiophiles take things a little bit too serious, and I don't. But I'll give a perspective from a normal guy standpoint. One of the first things I'll comment about is how nice the packaging is. When I got it, it came in this nice box. It's got a nice setup here. You've got your quick setup. You've got some other stuff. Came in a real nice bag. And it has comes with all the cords you need. Set it up immediately. It's got like the European power cord. It's got Ethernet and it's got RCA. I'll say I'm not using any of it except the power cord for America. But the packaging is super nice. Comes with quick setup guide, which is helpful. But I'll go over setup here in a minute. Now, first, I won't be comparing this with other streamers, mainly because I've never owned a streamer before except for my laptop, which, I'd stream iTunes, some FLAC files, and it never streamed them very well. So I was never very impressed. And I'd do YouTube videos and music off my laptop, kind of fun to do, but sounded okay, but it just never sounded that good to me. I really like CDs much better, so it took me a long time to really think about getting into the streaming game. I finally broke down when my wife urged me to. So my wife and I went to the store in Albuquerque. Since we've moved here, we're looking for places. Anyway, we found Listen Up. And a really nice guy there named Scotty. With the name alone, I had to love him. He's a great guy. I talked to him about streamers, and he highly recommended the Blue Sound Node 2i because of the price and the fact that I'm a tightwad and cheapskate. And he let my wife and I listen to it. And my wife was super impressed almost right away because, hey, we had access to all this music without having a bunch of CDs and crap in the house. Now, I did break down and start putting CDs in drawers, and we have some in the closets and stuff, but, to hide them. But, of course, she just wants those things gone. And I don't blame her too much. I like my CDs, but, hey, the streaming, yeah, they sold her on that right away. So, what about setup, you may ask? Well, let's get into that. With setup, it works pretty easy. I mean, setting it up is simple enough. Probably the biggest issue was once you hit the permissions, when you agree to the permissions, it seems to get stuck. Both my wife and I have Samsung phones, and it just seemed to get stuck for a while. So, setup took a lot longer than it should have, just because of the permissions. The setup was easy. Getting it going was super easy. So, you get it hooked into your network. This device can be hooked up on Wi-Fi, which is the way I have it. I don't have it hardwired. I don't use a lot of features on it, so I won't talk about those, such as Bluetooth, etc. But it has some super neat features. One is it's got its own free radio stations and such that you can use. Great addition to it. Now, for years, I was anti-streaming just because I think I was more afraid of it than anything. Because now that I'm doing it, I'm wondering why I took so long. I always thought CDs sounded better, and they sound pretty damn good. But some of the streaming, wow, the quality of the songs are just so much better. So there's a couple things I was working with. One, you can see I've got an external DAC, an old Cambridge DAC Magic. And then I've got it hooked up two ways. So one is using the DAC of the Blue Node, BlueStream Node 2i. One is using the DAC through the Cambridge. And, you know, I go back and forth. I really think that when I go through the BlueStream, the highs are a bit brighter, the mid-range more pronounced. And I personally lean towards the more warm tones I'm getting from the Cambridge. So I use it a lot more than I use the DAC through the Blue Node. Once again, that's personal taste. People will have different tastes on that and feel different ways. But I normally will run that through my Cambridge DAC, which is hooked up in a balanced setup into my Emotiva XSP1. And the Blue Node is hooked up through RCA cables into the Emotiva preamp. Both sound really good. Both beat the CD. It's unfortunate because I'm such a CD nut, and when I listen to CDs, I love them still. But when I listen to streaming with the high resolution files, yeah, they're better. I do like them. Really good. I can switch back between all three of these. So with the button, I click and it goes through the DAC of the Node 2. Switch it again, it goes through the Cambridge. Switch it again, I can listen to the same music on the CD. And I've done that quite a bit to compare. And like I say, the streaming definitely beats the CD. Now for streaming, I'm using Qobuz. I tried Tidal for a while on their free demonstration, but I just didn't like it. And I kept thinking $20 a month is too much for Tidal. At Qobuz, it is $15 a month. I'm still thinking that's a bit much, but I'm willing to pay it. My wife seems to really like it. She's learned to navigate it really quick and easy, which she likes, because then she's able to listen to my system where before she was afraid to touch it. Now that she just turns it on and hits her Qobuz and starts playing, she's happy as can be. I just leave it on the right setting for her so she doesn't have any issues. Makes it nice and simple so even us older folks can figure it out and do it. Oh, there's Metallica. Love them. Especially Master of Puppets. Wow. Sanitarium. Anyway, I like all kinds of music. I'm really more into jazz type stuff at this point in time in my life. But man, I still love my heavy metal days. And I'm a hair metal guy too. I really love hair metal. Anyway, so I can have a little bit of everything with Qobuz. I mean, it works good. It hooked into the Blue Sound Node 2. It works great. So that's the first thing I really am impressed with. The sound is great. It's cheaper than Tidal, but yet you still get the high res files. It's really good. You can see here on their website, you do have access to internet, radio stations, cloud music service, and your own local library. I can play music off my phone and my laptop. I have the app on my laptop, and I can play files off of it. So it works out pretty good. I run everything through Wi-Fi, but the internet radio stations that are free, I mean, you really could get a Node 2i and just listen to music on these internet radio stations and probably be pretty happy. So you'd only have the cost of the unit. I personally like some of the high resolution files, so that's why I use Qobuz. It does add to the sound quality and it sounds really good. Now setup is really easy. Adding songs into your playlist and such from Qobuz is really easy. I did find at times it took a while for my playlist on Qobuz to update to the playlist on my BlueStream. I don't know why that is, because we have really good internet service here. But it sometimes would take a while. In fact, one time I even had to turn the phone off and turn it back on for everything to update properly. Not sure why that is. But that being said, if you load songs onto your Bluestream app through Qobuz, they appear immediately. If you load them onto your Qobuz app, sometimes they don't appear immediately on the Bluestream app. So just keep that in mind. And like I say with the DAC, the internal and external DAC, there are some differences. So I'll kind of go over those. I did find the Cambridge DAC to be much more warm on the mid-range and the highs. The blue sound a little more pronounced. Some people probably like that. I personally like the warmth better. Like I say, both definitely beat the CD player. I do have that hooked up as a player, not a transport. So I basically wanted everything to be hooked up by XLR cables. So even my DAC runs balanced into the preamp. The CD player runs balanced into the preamp. The Node 2i does not. It runs through the RCA cables, like I say. And the other thing that you might note is that my Cambridge only goes up to 96. It doesn't go up to the 192. So that could be a difference in the sound too. Amazingly, like I say, I prefer the sound of the Cambridge DAC Magic. Why? Probably because I'm used to it. You know, sometimes a good old blanket is much nicer than a new one, whether it's warmer or not or wore out. It's just because it's familiar, and that may be the case here. Okay, let's listen to the different DACs. We'll call this A. To get going here. Then let's go to B. A. Maybe let me know in the comments down below which one you like better. We'll go back to B. And A. All right, we'll call it good right there. Let me know which one you like better, A or B. And I'll let you know which they are after I get a few comments on it. So all in all, this has been an excellent purchase. Probably spent more on it than I could have gotten it about $100 cheaper if I did it online and got a refurbished one. But of course I'm very adamant about supporting our local brick and mortar stores. If you can support them, please do. Anything you can buy from them just helps them out, especially in these tough times. Even if you order it online, order it from your brick and mortar store people, please. Support them all you can. It's going to be a rough stretch here. But with that being said, my wife seemed to know this was coming. She prepared. And one of the things she did to prepare was to get that little guy right there. That way we could have endless music and not be saddled to just what we have on in our CD and album library, which I gotta say, so far it's been a godsend. I'm glad she looks in advance, stocked up on food and water and everything before everybody went on their mad rushes. My wife's a good lady. Anyway, so with that being said, I highly recommend the Node 2i Streamer. It has a lot more features than I use, and as I use it and get accustomed to it, and if I use other features, I'll do another video to update it. Well, everybody, thank you for watching. This is the Amazing Papa, and I hope you got something out of this. If you have any questions or comments, let me know down below.